You master your emotions, you begin to lead wherever you find yourself. Some women meet a man on the road, or you meet a woman and think, this woman is better than my wife. You know, because at that particular point, their negative emotions are yet to come forth. So you don't know how they can react to the things your wife or your husband has been tolerating. You know, so
you are welcome to Speaking Peace Family Channel. Don't forget to like, to share, and to subscribe. We are glad to have you. God bless you.
Hello people, my name is Uduak Akman, you can also call me Buff. I'm the author of the book, The Viral Faith, and today quickly I want us to look at what I call the speaking emotions. The speaking emotions. A lot of us do not know that our emotions daily speak, but they communicate what you've been able to internalize, how you've been able to internalize our environment, you know, our responses to what we see, you know, what we see, what we hear, what we feel, and of course about a particular situation or particular environment. And so that's why you see that the emotions daily speak, and only if you can understand what they speak to you, what they say to you, then you will be able to master, you know, your relationship. You'll be able to master self and begin to enjoy your relationship. At the end of this video, I can tell you that you are going to begin to listen and begin to be able to relate to everyone, you know, in your life. Some people are enforced on us, you know, like your colleagues in the office, and of course in marriage you choose, but some things connect you. So for the purpose of this particular video, we're going to limit it to marriage. And because I've seen a lot of people, you know, individuals go into divorce, you know, just because they felt that they no longer love each other. But the point is that at that particular point where they feel they don't love each other, their emotions actually communicate something they don't understand. So they feel that what their emotion is communicating is that I don't love this woman again, I don't love this man again. So and that's why you see that they end up, you know, in divorce. But the point is that the moment, you know, divorce or they sign those papers, they begin to miss each other. And so that's why you see that paying attention to what our emotion speaks per time can actually save us in taking a lot of good decisions in life, and of course not making a lot of mistakes in life. You know, so you see Jesus Christ even used emotions very well. You want to look at Hebrews, you know, 4:15 talks about that Jesus Christ was touched by the feelings of our infirmities yet without sin, and that's because he was in control of the same. You also want to look at Matthew 9:36. Jesus Christ, you know, when he saw the crowd, he was moved with compassion. And so that's why you see that you need to pay good attention to your emotions. At the moment you can do this, one thing I know is that I've never seen anyone that has been able to master emotions very well that leadership roles do not call onto. One thing is that the moment you master your emotions, you begin to lead wherever you find yourself. Our emotions are like dogs, you know, knowing how to tame or train them determines, you know, what happens to us with them. You know, those are pets that can be wonderful, they can be best of friends, but the point is that if you do not communicate the real thing to them, then definitely they can become wild and begin to fight everyone that comes around you. So is our emotions. You know, your emotions begin to chase people around you. People don't want to spend time with you because your emotions are, you know, is communicating negative to them. And that's one thing you need to begin to understand. That's why you see that, like I said before, that individuals have gone into, you know, into divorce just because they did not understand what their emotions were saying at that particular time. They felt, I don't love this woman, I don't love this man anymore. But the point is, just like I asked before, that the moment you say you sign those papers, then some days after you just begin to look at what just happened to me, why did I leave this man, I love this man. But the point is that you forgot, you didn't, because you did not understand what the emotions are saying that particular time. And that's why you saw that people make a lot of mistakes in their lives, just because they do not understand what their emotion is saying per time. And so our emotions, you know, individuals seeking to get married in life, two individuals seeking to get married in life, a man and a woman, you know, they have three levels of connection. And the first one is our emotions. Our emotions is the first point of connection we have. Have you ever heard about love at first sight? But one thing you need to know is that rather than calling it love at first sight, because that's the language world understand, for me I call it, you know, connection at first sight. You see somebody, you know, on the street or somewhere in the church or wherever in an environment, and you just discover that there's a particular connection. Just that's just because your emotions, you know, they call it chemistry, you know, connect at that particular time. Then you now begin to build on that particular thing. Of course, second point, of course, it's spiritual. So the moment you go to altar or whatever you do, go to the registry before people, discover that you are connected spiritually before God. And that's why you see that you take vows, and those vows you stand by them. The moment you violate them, then you are hurting somebody. You are beginning to break a spiritual law. And that's why the Bible says that For this reason shall a man leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. The closest science or mathematics can do in calculating this particular how 1 + 1 becomes 1 is to tell you that they become one in unity. And so that leads us to the next thing. So like the first one is you are connected first emotionally. Second, you are connected secondly spiritually. Then the third thing is that you are now connected in purpose, which is the third thing. That's why you see that marriage that will last, marriage that will go or overcome the test of time, is marriage that have been able to unite in purpose. The moment you see a man facing different direction and a white woman facing another direction, then just a question of time, that marriage cannot last. And that's why you see that, but the point one of them submit, or except one of them submit, that's why you see that they can continue to go on and on. So you see that they can go on and on and on and on in life, and they remain together, you know, till they grow old in life. And one thing is that because one goal keeps them together, but the moment two individuals in marriage begin to get interested in two different things, then just a question of time. And that actually tells you why a lot of people go into divorce, because sometimes we get the distractions, you know. Sometimes in the office, some women meet a man on the road, or you meet a woman and think, this woman is better than my wife, you know, because at that particular point their negative emotions are yet to come forth. So you don't know how they can react to the things your wife or your husband has been tolerating, you know, so much in the house. And so that's why you see that people go into wrong relationships, and the moment you divorce they go out of the first marriage, discover that they cannot last in the other marriages. So you see them, they keep jumping from one man or one woman to the other, and like that over time, because they are now focusing on two things. Marriage is supposed to be about one thing, and the man has been given the power, the authority, you know, to lead that woman, you know, based on Ephesians. Ephesians says that the man is the head of the wife. Like I said, I've made this correction that God did not say that the man is the head of the family. A lot of men might not want to listen to this. God said that the man is the head of the woman. So it means that the two of them, the man and the wife, are the head of the family. So that's why I say that their decisions, opinions matter so much. The opinion of the woman is very important in marriage. The opinion of the man is very, very important in marriage. And like that's why I want to quickly say something about submission. Submission, on the other hand, is a two-way thing. Most men will not want to hear this, but I'm sure that a lot of us jump that the two should submit unto themselves in God. So that's one thing, you think that there are times that you see that the shine of that particular marriage is of the woman. And you cannot fight it. When you fight it, you are fighting the growth of your marriage. That's why you need to let that woman explore what she wants to, you know, what we want to explore under God. I'm not talking about when the woman is doing something contrary to the will or the purpose of God for their lives, but I'm talking about something that is under God. You need to let that woman shine, and supporting that woman at that particular time gives glory to that marriage. But a lot of men are insecure. I heard about a case where somebody went to meet a pastor and said, "Why do you let your wife go to the TV ministry?" And the man said, "You saw my wife on TV." He said, "Yes, have you not been watching? That means your wife is not even submissive, and she did not even tell you what she's doing." But the man said, "Are you really sure? Which station?" The man that came to gossip said, "On this particular station." And he said, "You saw my wife?" He said, "Yeah, I saw your wife on the particular time. What's the program?" And he said, "The name of the program is Sophia. You think you are seeing my wife? If you are seeing my wife, then you are seeing me." And that shot the man that came to gossip. That's because a lot of men have separated themselves from their wives. And at the moment you do that, then you become two people. But if you see yourself as your wife, and you see your wife as yourself, like the Bible said, the two of them are one. You cannot love yourself and not love your wife. So if you hate your wife, it means you do not love yourself, because your wife is you. And that's one thing you need to understand. So that's why you see that one purpose is very, very, very important. Submission is a two-way thing. So man with this understanding, you know, have enjoyed the fruits, you know, of their marriages, you know, through their wives. I've heard about a particular case where the wife earns the largest salary. The husband earns so little salary. But the point is that you will never know. You will never know. They have cars, they have investment, they have houses. But the point is that the woman is actually, say this out for people to know. Even the family of the woman, does not know that the man is not the one bringing the money. That's because the woman has been able to submit, and that man taught that woman to submit. Over time, when that man was better in terms of financially, you know, over time, the man never hid anything from the woman. The woman knows how much he earns and all those things. So over time, the woman grew up to becoming what, you know, the man trained the woman, you know, to be. Just like Ephesians says that, you know, that you might present them, the women to themselves as spotless or not, without any wrinkle. So it is what your woman becomes is what you have trained her, you know, to be. So a lot of marriages have been blessed because from men that understand that, you know, this particular marriage, let me not fight this particular thing my wife is bringing to the table. And so that particular thing, and it helps a lot. And that's why you see that submission has to go, you know, has to be a two-way thing. And under God, the woman can submit, the man can also submit. And that's one thing you need to do. Go and think about. So, but the point is that this is not often emphasized, you know, in our churches, in our homes. But the point is that a lot of us need to pay more attention to this particular, so that we do not deny our wives or do not deny God, what God wants to do through our wives in our marriages. So that's why I say that purpose must be one. For you to be able to be unified in that particular marriage. Now, how do you understand what your emotions are saying per time? How do you understand what your emotions are saying per time? That is the key thing that will keep your marriage, that will keep you unified with that woman, that will make you be able to enjoy your relationship, even with your wife and even with your people around you. So one good way, like I said here, is to seek the joy of others. I'm taking a pause. Is to seek the joy of others. You cannot give joy and not have it. You cannot give sacrifices, you know, and not have things sacrificed unto you. And that's why you see that when you seek the interest of others above yours, in this particular case right now, your wife or your spouse, you seek the interest of your spouse, you always put him or her ahead of you in everything you do, then definitely you begin to understand the fact that no, this woman deserves better than myself, or this man deserves better than that. At the moment you begin to give that, then your wife will communicate, or your husband will communicate the same. The moment you begin to give that, then definitely your husband or your wife, you know, whichever case it might be, will begin to communicate the same thing to you, because it there's no how sacrifice does not get response, and the response it gets also is love, or, you know, giving in sacrifice. Sacrifice, you know, sacrifice is what builds. Sacrifice is what builds. You know, the sacrifice you give in whatever you are doing, you know, for your home or for your marriage, that's what actually builds a marriage. They are the language of selfless emotions. Sacrifice is the language of selfless emotions. There is no how somebody sees the language of selfless emotions and do not respond with empathy or with love. And that's one thing you really need to understand. However, there are two types of sacrifices in marriage. There are sacrifices you give because you are expecting the other person to give back to you at that particular time in the same measure. But that's where a lot of us miss it. You do everything for that man because you are expecting that man to do the same thing for you. And sometimes it might not be. When the man is going to do the same thing, it can't be in the same measure. That's why I said that the example I gave, that when the man was any better than the wife, he did not let that woman lack anything. So the moment the woman began to earn better than the man did not lack anything. As a matter of fact, the woman submitted her salary, you know, her income, everything to that man, because that man has communicated the same thing when that man was in a better position. And so that man did not fight that woman becoming better than himself. He understood the whole thing that, come, for this particular time in our marriage, in our home, this woman is who God is using to bless us, and the woman is supporting the man. They, like I said, they have cars, and they are doing very well. So the second type of sacrifice in marriage that we really need to pay attention to is a sacrifice with no expectation. It's the same thing Jesus Christ did for us. You won't say you are not Jesus Christ, but the point is that, you know, Jesus Christ, Paul says something like that, my children whom I travel until Christ be formed in you. There's an expectation that Christ should be formed in us. Do that to your wife, do that to your husband, and you will get the result. I can tell you something, that particular marriage will stand the test of time and will go extra mile, even when either of the, you know, spouses make a mistake. But because of the foundation they have laid, they can stay together in life. God bless you real good. If you have listened, God will really, you know, improve and impact, you know, the same to you, even more than what we have shared. God bless you real good. The name is Uduak Akman. You can also call me Bob. But don't forget to subscribe. This is your first time on this particular channel. And don't forget to share also. This can actually save a lot of marriages. And don't forget to like also. I'm going to be bringing out the second part of this video, you know, for those in workspace, how you can relate with your colleagues in the environment, in whatever environment, or your in-laws, you know, in-laws that have actually been, you know, feeding you or sending negative signals to you, how to handle them and what you can do. So please stay tuned to this particular channel, subscribe so you can, and click, you know, the bell button so you can get notifications the moment we upload other forms of video. God bless you.